Hi, my name is Brittany Nicholas. I've been waiting 7 months to exhale, and I'm tired of waiting. This is what came up with it. What will it take? What will it take for you to get your knee off my neck? Shall I run out into the middle of the street and lie there? Should I walk out into the ocean and pray the waves carry me away? Shall I climb to the top of the highest mountain and believe I can fly? What will it take for you to get your knee off my neck? Should I claim instability, insanity, and consume high amounts of your poisons? Shall I announce I'm invincible and challenge that no sickness, no disease, both naturally occurring and contrived, can affect me? Should I join your army, travel around the world and proclaim I am bulletproof? What? What will it take for you to get your knee off my neck? See, black and brown folks have been living in a world plagued by a pandemic long before the coronavirus. Surviving has been our prerogative and main objective for generations. But now, I believe we've come to a point, reached the end of a line, broke the camel's back beyond repair. Things have become, and our every waking day is aggravatingly unbearable. I often think of the many wise men and women who've come before, petitioning for a little peace sometimes. And I've come to realize that even the lesser of yours are afforded this privilege without provocation. So here I ask, they ask, we ask, what will it take for you to get your knee off our neck? Seems like the answer is nothing and never. But that's just me projecting. But I have noticed that my happiness causes you great pain, anger, and destruction. It's what makes you the most monstrous. Stealing sons and daughters, mothers and fathers, all slain for reasons only you understand. I'll put it to you like this. Is it because I won't lay down and die why you hate me so much? I only ask that aloud to give you the opportunity to think about it. But what I really want to know is, what will it take for you to get your knee off my neck? If I take my gun out into the middle of the street and fire several rounds into the sky, it is to proclaim that I am here and I ain't going nowhere. And that would be my right to live. And just know, it wouldn't take much to level that gun. 'Cause truth be told, I didn't just buy it for my protection. So here, at the end of the line, now deserving punctuation, I feel it's only fair to ask this one last time. And I hope we get an acceptable answer. What will it take for you to get your knee off my neck?
Is the sheep preaching hate when he says, I'm not going to let the wolf eat me anymore? If the wolf comes in here, next time he comes in here, I'll do whatever I have to do to keep him off my back. Is the sheep violent or is the wolf the violent one? He wasn't teaching hate, he was teaching common sense. You know, somebody's knocking you over the head, stop them. Do whatever you have to do to stop them. You know, the ones that were knocking him over the head were afraid of the fact that he might swing back, so they said, no, he's teaching hate, he's violent.